Hey guys, what is going on? It is Offspring, and it's been a long time coming. Here it is. Dallara DW12 IndyCar. I've already done a lot of laps in it in a previous practice session, but I still got some tweaking to do, so let me get out here and see how many laps I can put in before I crash. I was given this setup in a previous session. I am not good with setups at all. I was actually given a really fast qualifying setup, but it required the use of the weight jacker, and man, I just can't remember to hit that weight jacker every single lap. So I got to put in enough laps to get my fuel and my tire strategy figured out. Thankfully, the setup is really stable. So the DW12, in case you didn't know, has been in the works for a while, and us IndyCar racers have been just shouting on the forums, bring it out, bring it out. And now it's finally here, and we're just thrilled to death. I mean, the car is wonderful, and it's ugly as hell. I hate the way it looks. I like the looks of the old car, but the thing I like about this one is I believe it's going to bring more people to IndyCar racing, and hopefully more to the road side of IndyCar, so I can finally get involved in some road races there, because I haven't been able to do any road racing in the IndyCar yet, primarily due to the fact that the only races that go official are during times that I'm not able to race. So this car just feels so good. It's definitely fast too. I'm gonna max out this the fuel here. Well, it's on 30 laps of fuel now, and I'm just gonna use it all up. Hopefully I can do that without crashing. Use up all the fuel and see what I've got left in the tires.
40.7, 4.8.
And I think I just lost that crash. Car. Now, I love the previous Indy car. The previous Indy car was wonderful, and not only that, it was a good-looking car. But you know, an aerodynamicist or engineer from Formula One was talking about how ugly the Formula One cars are these days, and they said that if the aerodynamicists and the engineers in the 70s, 80s, and 90s knew what they know today, the cars would have been uglier then too. But that's just a crying shame that you got to make an ugly car to make it aerodynamically efficient. This car is also in real life supposed to be safer, because it's more difficult to interlock the wheels, because we've got the back wheels closed. So I don't even know if you can call it an open-wheel race car anymore.
40.7,
I guess since the front wheels are open, you can call it that. Lap's just getting better and better. This is fantastic. I just want to give a shout-out to Richard Dingman at RDR Racing for giving me this setup. He He was sharing it one person at a time in a previous room, and then somebody said, man, just share it with everybody. So he finally just shared it with everybody. So with the stipulation that if you did any good with it, you have to give him credit. And sure enough, I'm giving it to him now. It's a great setup.
40.673.
Now this is not a qualifying setup. This is a race trim setup. And I'm hoping somebody doesn't pull out in front of me. I'm wanting to get the full, at least 29 laps in. Man, when you catch a draft going to these corners, it is ridiculous. I'm having to lift just so I can catch the steer. There's that understeer. Yeah, that draft will get you. Oh, no. Oh, thank you.
Okay.
Go far bottom.
Yeah, I gotta get. Need to get quite a bit more practice.
0-2.
Last thing I want to do is get an Indy 500 and crash in the seventh lap. We'll be racing the Indy 500 Saturday, by the way, and I'm hoping I don't get taken out early. There's nothing I hate more than preparing all week for a race, and there's only gonna be. That's what I hate. You know, they're racing on Friday and Saturday this time, and I have to work Friday. So the only race I can make is Saturday. So if I get wrecked out or something, it's over. No second chance for me. But I guess that's how it is in real life. But shit, I'm not doing this for real life. You know, I'm not making whatever it is, $1 million if I win. You know? Doing this for fun. Surviving. Happy about that.
40.648.
Guys, I'm going to try to do commentary during the Indy 500 this year. It'll be my first Indy 500. Try to do commentary, but it is very difficult for me to focus on what I'm doing and talk at the same time. If you're hearing some background noise, that is my air conditioner running. It's like 87 degrees outside, and if I didn't have the air conditioner on, it'd be 95 in my house.
So, four, six.
Yeah, it's a window unit because our central air conditioner sucks. I actually recorded this. I recorded a video similar to this last night, but I made a stupid comment based on something that I saw on the forums on my phone. I was reading the forums from my phone, and somebody mentioned no tire wear. And I said, is this a bug? And he said, yes, it's a bug. But what I didn't know is he was talking about the picture that he had posted.
40.6,
in which the front tires were lifted up off the ground. So he was saying that since your tires aren't touching the ground, there won't be any tire wear. It was kind of a little joke. And I took that to mean that the tires were somehow glitched where they didn't show tire wear, which was a problem in a couple of the F1 games, I think. So I've decided just to start it over. My first few laps in this car were non-memorable. similar to the laps I'm having right now. Nothing's going on, nothing's happening, everything's cool.
40.613.
I did wreck a few times while testing out some different setups. And the funny thing is, the baseline setup in this car seems to be, if you're going to jump into this car for the first time and you've never driven the Indy cars before, if you jump in that baseline setup, you can just scoot around this track at maybe a second or two off the pace. It's a pretty big difference in oval racing, but when you qualify, you know, if you're near the back of the pack, you'll have some people to race with, there's no doubt. Once again, you know, this setup, given to me by Richard Dingman, who shared it with the entire practice session. Everybody in that room got this setup. And once again, you'd have to stay in fifth gear, unless, of course, you get in the draft, and then you got to switch up to sixth. I think my fuel is burning down now because I'm starting to top out there into the main straight. I'm going to do a few more laps and do some calculations on my fuel use and see what my tire wear looks like. Right now the tires feel fine. But it's only been 16 laps. During the race, I haven't decided yet if I'm going to leave ice speed up during the race, because I like to have the full screen showing. Occasionally, if you do windowed mode like this, some update or something will pop up in the bottom right-hand corner, and you'll fly into a wall, because the screen will lose focus from what you're actually doing with your excellent racing. So, slow down. What's this guy doing? I think he's dipping his toe in the water, so to speak. Maybe he just jumped into the car and hasn't driven yet. Throwing issues into my fuel calculation, though, this is going to kind of mess those up. But I guess in the race, I'll be behind somebody, hopefully. Or, hopefully, everybody will be behind me. But I seriously doubt that.
40.86.
Man, that draft is a killer. Somebody on the forums actually called it overpowered. I don't know about overpowered, but it's definitely a major factor now. It wasn't that big a factor in the old Indy cars, but it's definitely a major factor now. I'm feeling it all through these turns. Just trying to catch somebody else's drive. And there he goes.
Stay to the bottom. In front of you. Go high.
Thank God it's a practice session. That's what they're for. Crash in practice. Get all you crashing over with in practice. You too.
No,
oh boy, I'm gonna hit this
one. In front of you there.
Oh,
stay
geez.
Up top, man.
That was close. So yeah, I use iRacing, I use iSpeed during my testing sessions like this, so that I can see when I'm gonna have to hit, this, that, and the other. And see what my, try to figure out what my fuel strategy, good grief, people! See what my fuel strategy is going to be, what my tire strategy is going to be, and I'll probably have to calculate how long it takes to fuel the entire car, and see if it'd be worth it to change tires at the same time. That's probably actually not even going to be a factor. I'll probably have to change either way. Chris Bourne, I've raced him before. Is that guy still flipping?
I'm
gonna stop at some point, right?
Maybe the same problem.
I think I've gone around you four times now and you're still flipping.
I don't know, I've used like 5 laps worth of fuel.
Keep digging, man. Start spot 10 entrance for me.
Gotta get digging.
14.49.
Stop!
All right, good question. What's the best way to convert your race setup to a qualifying setup?
Use qualifying boost if it helps.
What?
He's still flipping!
Take out fuel and make sure you set it to qualifying boost to give you more power.
Any recommendation on how much fuel to take out?
Well, I'll take 4.5 gallons.
Leave in 4.5 gallons.
So, did you stop something?
40.478.
I did. I'm not watching the replay of myself tumbling.
Pretty good, because I'm still going.
This is dizzying.
On that entrance, we're going to pit next time.
Did you still come?
40.568.
13.618. Car is sitting in the middle of the track. Stay in the bottom, stay in the bottom. Outside. Clear. 6, 9, 5.
Helped him, I said, a big time.
The race is bad. I'll stay a little bit longer on the run.
Chase, you said you had trouble with the setup?
40, 26, 5, 6.
Yeah, I have no idea what I'm doing with the setup.
Go and check to see under the share section in the garage menu. Check to see if there's setups there. Anybody with the name of... Oh shit, that's his name. Just go check to see if there's any shared setups in there. And if not, I'll share the one that the guy gave me.
Wyatt Foster shared a ball setup with this morning.
40.813.
Yeah, there's no
chair
setup.
The only one that's got a yellow helmet, something Dingersman or something Dingersman. Whoever that is, he gave me a setup, and I was the same boat as you, Jason. I had no idea what I was doing. And he showed the setup. It is extremely stable. Extremely stable, which is perfect for me because I'm new to this stuff.
Yeah, same here. I just got it earlier tonight.
Yeah, then you're gonna want this set up. Stay in this room. I'm gonna finish off my fuel run here, and then I'll share it with you.
40.69.
Because he shared it to just about everybody in the room, and he told us, you know, if anybody else needs it, to just dish it out to whoever.
Yeah, that would be great. Happy to share the setup. I'm really struggling. How do we download the setup? I've never done that before.
If I have to share it, I'll post it up to everyone when I'm done my fuel run. But what you do is you go to the garage options, you know, where you can look at your setup, and then all the tabs on the side where it's like my setup, load setup, there should be a tab that says shared setups, and if you click on it, it should say all the setups that were shared in the room or not. I'll be sharing with you guys shortly because some guy just hooked me up.
Yeah, I see it. Thanks for that. I'll check it out later. That's right.
I can use that. I don't have a qualifying setup. I just have my race trim set up.
That's great, thanks.
40.7.
Yeah, that's really cool, man. Thanks.
I got about
14
laps left
on my fuel. I'm going to share my race trim set up with you guys now. It's a little bit, I mean, you're giving up a little bit of speed to make it stable, but especially if you're new, you definitely need a stable car.
Yeah, I was pretty comfortable in the old Indy car, but struggling with this one a bit, so yeah, that was great, thank you.
Alright, now it's Jason Barrett, and who was the last one I was just talking?
40.521.
All right, I'm just going to share the setup with everybody. Hold on.
You want the switch?
Yeah, I appreciate that. I'll drop on the faster.
Jason, I just shared it with you and I shared it with Chris too.
Cool, thank you.
Yeah, thanks Matt, just say that, that's right, thank you very much.
inside. Clear inside.
Yeah, no problem. Like I said, if it's just a little bit slower on once you get in the drift, it'll be okay. But like I said, it is extremely stable. You could really full throttle out around these corners. You don't have to fight the wheel or anything. Especially for beginners, it is a phenomenal setup.
Can I get an ultimate?
If I'm not mistaken, I shared it to everybody. If you check and it's not there, I'll share it to everybody again. Just double check for me.
Hey, Matt, did I see you?
Why, yes, you did.
Yeah, I got it.
Hey.
Inside, clear.
Yeah, no problem.
I wasn't trying to bug you, 34. I was just trying to practice the draft.
Sorry. Yeah, I'm going to do the same thing, James.
Mike, did you ever share your call front card? That's one thing I don't have yet. People that are generous in these rooms.
Chances are slim of them getting to the same split anyway. There's gonna be a lot of people.
Yeah, no doubt it's gonna be a stud.
My first time doing this race ever. I just bought it like a day ago, so.
It'll be my first Indy too. But I have been doing the race TV card a couple times.
High.
the same setup in there twice with not the same people?
What was that?
I'm just looking in the shared setup, and there's two in there, one with everyone and one for team. I just want to check, is it the same setup?
Yeah, because I just shared it to you and Jason, and a few more people asked for it, so I just decided to share it with everybody. It's the same setup.
Get a look at your pin and just start getting a look at it.
Yeah, well, thanks for that.
It's been a lot since you guys running a race from all alone.
I was running like 44s, 43s, 45s, around there.
I'm basically in the same range as here.
But the setup that I'm running, whoever gave it to me, it's more of like a stable setup. She took off shape and speed off, so it's really, really difficult to drive.
Are you upshifting for six, or are you holding it in six?
I keep it in six. I upshift it in six.
It's a really nice long run, sir, I can tell you that.
Oh yeah, so stable.
I think for a long race, that's what you want.
My car's starting to pick up speed now, I'm burning the oil off.
Sorry. I like it because I think I put that on the car yesterday, so I'm not used to it. But it's so stable, it makes it so difficult to drive. Just a little bit.
Still there. Clear. 40.553. But all around your pit, hit this time. Slow one up top. Talk to stay on the bottom.
Did I lose you, James?
Oh. Yeah, I got a fifth of fuel.
James, is that your setup? James, is that your setup, or is that one of the iRacing sets?
The one I was running was given to me by somebody in a previous session. Guys, I think that's going to do it for right now. That was a lot of fun. Pretty intense.
I'll share my setup. It's a lot less stable probably than the setup that's already shared, but I'll share it anyways.